Like every big tech guy, Bill Gates is thinking about the metaverse, and we can expect the future of online meetings to soon join us in our daily life thanks to Microsoft and their aim to get this done as fast as possible. Hello and welcome back to our channel. Today we will discuss the metaverse Mr. Gates has mentioned about, but before we get into the video, give us a like and subscribe if you want to be the first to receive updates when we come out with a new video. So let's go! In a recent article on his personal website, Bill Gates stated that "I predict most virtual meetings will shift from 2D camera image grids, which he refers to as the Hollywood Squares model, to the metaverse, a 3D place with digital avatars." In a year-end post on Gates' personal blog, the Microsoft co-founder included a prediction about the future of work and how it could be changed by the rise of the metaverse. The virtual worlds being built by tech companies like Meta and Microsoft, where users will be able to work, play, and socialize. Gates stated that the COVID-19 pandemic has already revolutionized the workplace, with more companies than ever offering flexibility for employees who want to work remotely. He expects that in the next 2 or 3 years, most workers would conduct virtual meetings in the metaverse. He also stated that the COVID-19 pandemic has already transformed the workplace, with most organizations now allowing employees to work remotely. Gates argued that these developments will only accelerate in the coming years, and that remote working will draw an increasing number of individuals into the metaverse. There is still work to be done. Bill believes that working in the metaverse will be a significant step up from what we currently get with most video conferencing platforms like Zoom or Microsoft Teams. In the metaverse, you would have a 3D avatar that could attend meetings in a virtual office space or another destination where it could interact with your co-workers. If you think Zuckerberg's metaverse is the only virtual area you'll have access to, think again. According to Bill Gates, Microsoft is working on incorporating 3D avatars and other metaverse-friendly components into its workplace. Now that Microsoft is partnering with Zuck to make Meta's workplace features for businesses compatible with Teams, software teams may have a clear path to the metaverse. However, as Bill pointed out, it will take time and willingness from users and their employers before a virtual workspace in the metaverse becomes a reality. It's also worth noting that tech companies like Meta are still developing the virtual worlds that will make up the metaverse. Bill confessed that pricey tech gadgets, such as virtual reality headsets and even motion capture gloves, will be required to effectively capture your expressions, body language, and voice quality. According to the Microsoft founder, Bill Gates, there's still a lot of work to be done. But it won't be long before the metaverse succeeds in making remote work feel less remote and more real. In terms of the metaverse's future, Zuckerberg is cautiously optimistic. As more companies try to get into the metaverse early, the major players are slowly starting to stake their claim at the top. The Meta CEO predicts that the key factors of metaverse will become famous in the next maybe 5 or more, 10 years. Earlier this year, Meta introduced Horizon Workrooms, a virtual reality app where people can congregate in virtual workspaces. Microsoft is now producing mixed and extended reality applications with holograms. Minecraft is also owned by the American IT giant. Another platform that kids can't get enough of is Roblox, a kid-friendly computer game that has evolved into its own virtual universe. Roblox has partnered with various brands, including Ralph Lauren Vans and Gucci, to deliver unique experiences to the metaverse. Many people believe that Microsoft understands the metaverse concept better than Meta, which is ironic because all you need to use mesh. Microsoft's gateway to the metaverse is your current smartphone or laptop. No clunky headsets or expensive setups are required, as is the case with Meta. Furthermore, judging by its approach, Microsoft is focusing on available capabilities and enterprise applications rather than Meta's vision of total lifestyle adoption. Microsoft Teams presently has around 145 million daily users who are also active, whereas the total number of installed VR headsets is only approximately 17 million. There's also the issue of privacy, which Meta was famous for during its Facebook days when whistleblower Frances Haugen released internal documents that highlighted Facebook's inconsistent application of moderation policies, accusing the company of prioritizing growth over safety. Meta has reassured its consumers that it is committed to data privacy in the metaverse, stating that the quantity of data collected will be kept to a minimum. On the other hand, enabling privacy-protecting data users and giving consumers transparency and control over their data may not be enough to reassure most prospective users. According to Global Data's social media, Microsoft is the market leader in data privacy. Microsoft stands in second place on the thematic scorecard when assessed by the top 10 social media themes. Industry, if you're still not persuaded that Microsoft can take over the metaverse, consider this. Meta is ranked 21st out of the 35 firms, and its data privacy practices could harm the company's future success. You've most likely never heard of the Xbox Museum. Many memories have been built around Microsoft's Xbox gaming platform, and the corporation has now devised a clever way to remind users of these experiences. Xbox owners can now wander a virtual space that displays a museum of highlights, or an Xbox Metaverse, which includes significant dates like when specific consoles launched and generation-defining mistakes like the infamous Red Ring of Death. You can also see the avatars of other Xbox owners browsing exhibits, adding to the feeling that you're in a Metaverse. The personal Xbox Museum, which displays a list of individual highlights, was the largest draw for most gamers. These include the gamers' most played game each year, their first game on each console, their first achievement in terms of hours and games played, and so on. However, would the early adopters be businesses or consumers with PCs? Businesses found use cases that added value and brought computers well before consumers found uses for expensive computers at home. The opposite was true for the smartphone, with consumers buying Apple iPhone for themselves and effectively forcing enterprises to make the software they needed work on them. To this point, virtual reality has been dominated by consumers, with Meta's Oculus brand gearing towards consumers from both an operational and pricing perspective, as we'd mentioned earlier, so it's hard to argue with that strategy right now. On the other hand, Microsoft has geared its VR and AR strategy to business use cases like engineering and construction, with a higher price point to match. These are high-value use cases for immersive technologies that are already helping build out the high end of the industry, but they're lower volume than consumer VR today. Microsoft isn't a big player in virtual reality hardware right now, but it could easily buy a company like HTC or Pico and have the hardware to compete with Meta in the enterprise market almost immediately. Or it could rely on third-party manufacturers to get hardware to market while focusing on software. But the antics don't stop with the Metaverse. Microsoft appears to be betting big on the neoliberal economy. According to CoinDesk, the tech giant's venture arm is leading a $27 million bet on an NFT studio called Palm. The funding will primarily be used to scale the company's operations with a slew of new hires. Palm works with brands and other companies in helping them create various NFT projects. In an interview with CoinDesk, M12 Managing Director Matt Goldstein said, "When we look at Palm's pipeline, we're focusing on early stage B2B. It's exactly the type of blockchain service that Microsoft and its M12 startup fund see promise in on an enterprise level. It's all media companies, art brands and content brands, and those are the partnerships we believe are most positioned to assist and promote the Microsoft Griffin Gaming Partners, re-decentralized autonomous organization. Third King Venture Capital, Permian Investment Palm, has already partnered with some famous names, such as the Space Jam 2 NFT collection and an NFT initiative with DC Comics for its DC fandom. 2021 is the year of the event. It'll be interesting to see how Microsoft navigates this new metaverse and NFT seas. And after going headfirst on all fronts, it's now a sink or swim situation for the company. What are your views on this? Is Meta the main leader of this metaverse, or Microsoft will be the new leader? Comment down your views and don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel. And we'll see you in the next one.